Amy here with an idea I'm really into of late, and also a giveaway, so stay tuned. We're going to make 3D embellishments out of flat embellishments, either ones that you buy or ones that you cut out. So let's get started. This is Imaginus die cuts shapes for a little baby. I actually bought it at Tuesday morning on sale, but whether you buy it on sale or not, this idea will not only be cool, but it also makes storage easier, makes using it easier, and it's less expensive than buying them pre-3D. So we've got some wee little ones, sweet baby. So what we're going to need for this is a piece of release paper. Release paper is nothing more than the backing sheet from stickers, name tags, that kind of thing that you would normally toss away, but you'll want to be saving them. The best glue ever. And some corrugated cardboard and a page protector. So the first thing we're going to do is just cut strips of corrugated cardboard, and you can use any thickness or whatever that you have. I do recommend cutting across the grain. If you'll notice, corrugated cardboard has these little lines that go this way, and if you cut across the grain, then every strip you have has corrugated right up to the edge. If you cut this way, you have the chance of cutting between the strips, and it just makes it a little bit less firm. Now you can cut them ahead of time, or you can see what you need for the individual die cuts or paper that you're using. Because I'm doing this for the video, I think I'll cut a bunch ahead of time. And then all we're going to do is glue the cardboard to the back and then glue them onto the release paper. It doesn't take very much glue to glue it onto the die cut because this glue is very tacky and strong. And then I'm going to add a fairly healthy size amount of glue, because what's going to happen is after this glue dries, it's going to turn clear and tacky like a glue dot, and then you'll just be able to lift this right off this release paper and apply it to your project. Oh, this must have been the piece, the fourth one that I did before. You can see it's starting to dry and it got very tacky. Actually attached itself to my finger. But I can still use it. And the other thing about the glue is you don't have to worry about it drying up and rushing, because if anything, the glue just gets tackier as it starts to dry. So. And you'll notice when I have big pieces, I don't worry about the cross or the, you know, going with the grain or whatever. It's only when it's a very thin strip that it's better to go across the grain to make sure that you get the corrugated on every bit of it. Just because it comes in one piece doesn't mean you have to use it all together. So what if we just cut this little one? There, so one more can fit. Now you have a little bit of time to move things around. Like you could see, this is already actually grabbed onto the die cut. I could move it if I really tried, but just by nudging it, it's not moving. So you do get a little bit of time for adjustment, which is nice. And that's it. And then we'll just let it dry. And then we'll just slip it into the sleeve, and this way you could keep them like in a book of die cuts, and it would be easy to put dividers. We could, you know, you could have birthday or baby or whatever, but it's easier than when you have a whole package of die cuts to sort through each time you're looking for something. Okay, one more quick frugal reminder. Before you throw anything away, see if there's something that you want. So this pack of paper things, it was called It's Your Day. This used to be just up here, and I decided to cut it off and save it as an embellishment. So I'll just make it 3D and put it into a sheet. Same with this. This was a, on the back, it was showing you what's included in this pack, and this was over here, but I think this would be cute as a little embellishment, and I could, you know, stamp something here or write their name or whatever. Now you could use the same idea with stickers, because I'm not really a sticker person. So, for example, we've got this sticker that says fun, and it just wouldn't be like me probably to put it down. So what I'm going to do is take the perfect crafting pouch, apply it to the back of the sticker to make it unsticky, and now we have a die cut that's not a sticker anymore, and I can just a pop-up card board. And create 3D embellishments, which I probably would use rather than a sticker. So you can see we're starting to get a page of the 3D embellishments from the stickers. And one last tip for making 3D embellishments. So I have this paper pack. Did buy it again at Tuesday morning for $2.99. And I just cut it up and ended up with all sorts of little pieces. So then there are some that are left over, that I think are just too big for a pop-up. I probably wouldn't use them on a pop-up at a card, although I might use them as background. So I can just always keep these and clip them to the sheet, stick them in the page protector, whatever. I think I'm actually finally using up this bottle, and the thing is, it really doesn't dry up. I don't know if you've noticed that in between using it, I can just leave it on my table, and I can get like every last bit of glue out of the bottle. But I think it's actually running out. I don't know how long I've had this bottle, but it's been a long time. So I didn't really explain why it would be on release paper, but that's so that when you're ready to use it, you can just remove it. It's got the sticky glue on the back that's all dry, and when you want to put it on a project, you would just put it down and it would stick. There you go. So the giveaway is for this sheet of baby embellishments.